You're listening to the Major Pod Network, the only place where your favorite toy store, bar, arcade, and arena are all on the same block. Scratch that major itch.
Welcome, everyone, to MC True Long Island Story, episode 19. I am your host, the internet champion, always ready and always ready to drink a major PBR stronger seltzer. Oh, yeah.
I'm also here, producer of the show.
I didn't even say my name, Mark.
Sorry.
Come on.
My bad.
Come on, Mark.
What's your name?
My name is Matt Cardona. Hi, my name is...
I've been actually listening to Eminem in the gym lately. Little Eminem playlist.
One thing that I always planned on doing, but never got around to doing because it was too difficult at the time. I wanted to, you know, I always spoof songs.
Oh, right.
I wanted to spoof one of those songs, one of those Eminem songs. I think it's that one.
Hi, my name is.
No, which one is the one where they're all, oh, like I'm Slim Shady. I wanted to spoof that and then like have like, well, the real like Zack Ryder, please, and have everyone with like Broski wigs and the headbands and the fists. I just couldn't, you know, I had like Big O, Stanford, my dad, Chipetta. I couldn't get extras.
Right. But I guess you could have, I nowadays the producer in me is like, oh, well, we crowdsource that. We get people to film their own wig things or whatever, but.
Yeah, well.
Well, I'm also here, producer of the show, Mark Sterling Esquire, Smart Mark Sterling Esquire, and I got a strong seltzer too, Wild Berry today. Let me tell you something. Father's Day, yesterday, as we record this, I climbed up a mountain with the family and drank some PBR at the top, and it was a wonderful day.
I was at Cedar Point. You can hear all about it on Majorland, Chelsea Green and I's theme park podcast, even though this is an amusement park, and they had PBR there.
Oh, nice.
They did, which was fantastic.
So I'm not familiar with this game. Cedar Point is like, from what I gather, like a roller coaster theme park, kind of?
It's like the roller coaster theme park. And I don't want to get into it that much here because it's not Majorland. But there was so much to do that I have to go back because we couldn't do it all.
Gotcha.
I think we did the best three and we did some other ones. But as we were leaving, I'm like, oh, we didn't do this. We didn't do that. So I got to go back.
Cool. Well, we had a big weekend. We tag teamed on Friday at AAW. Really cool, packed house. That was fun.
No, in the ring. Nothing sexual here.
Right. Well, what else would I mean? Tag team that AAW was great. We lost. My bad. Lost the contact though. I think that's why we lost. I was missing an eye, basically.
Yeah. I lost my shoulder. No, it's all good.
Ryan lost his face.
In there with Stiffy McGee.
Right.
No, it was a fun atmosphere. AIW was so cool. And it was a weird dynamic because within the course of what, a 20, 25 minute match, we were babyface heels. It's like they would boo me, but then cheer me if I did something like signature or something cool. It was so cool.
It was tough. I mean, it was like Cena 2011 or whatever the heck.
I was having like a hell of a great time. It was a cool match, cool to be out there, and really like the first time the
figure four, as you like to say.
We do a lot of stuff together, but first time we actually all teamed up. So
well, yeah, so actually to be honest, I said that on the internet, but we did team together at the toy drive, but I said that was an unsanctioned match because it was originally me and Swoggle versus Spite, and then it turned into a four-way. So
this was
the first sanctioned professional wrestling match with the figure four. And then Toyhio, which was great, and we had a ball, and we'll talk a lot about that on the Major Wrestling Figure Podcast. I'm wearing the shirt right now.
Oh, I didn't get a shirt.
I asked him. I was like, oh, man, it's really cool. It's like a Macho Man-esque.
It's black. I don't do black tees.
Ever? I prefer really a colored shirt, but. I'll take a black.
I have like the dogs and the cats and like the hair gets on it. I just can't do it.
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah, but it was a very busy, busy weekend. I'm very, very tired right now, but you know, the show must go on.
Right. Successful. And we're thrilled to get back into podcasting this week. We got a lot to do. All right. Well, follow up from last week. Anything from you?
So my rule, not my rule, but I typically don't like to go back and watch my old stuff, especially because, you know, I got, this is going to sound so ridiculous to say, but I got signed to WWE so early in my wrestling career and in my life. I was 20 years old that my growing pains, if you will, happened on television. You know, I didn't do it in high school gyms and bingo halls where in matches we'll never see. Mm-hmm. All of my stuff is documented, really. I mean, you know, I did indies, but come on, like,
yeah,
for
yeah,
a cup for of coffee. Sure. So that's why I like to watch that stuff back is like cringeworthy to me, you know?
Right. Yeah.
But somebody did post the promo that I did on Superstars on Long Island. And something that I thought was really, really funny is that, like you said, Brandi Rhodes was the ring announcer.
Yeah.
And I go to get the mic from her and she shakes my head.
Oh, yeah. I remember that. I meant to bring that
up.
Oh, my
God. With the mic.
Yeah. She's probably thinking, like, he's not doing a promo on Superstars. That was great. All right.
That's
well,
all I
a
really
couple. Couple things on YouTube. Needless Thing says that beer bash story broke my effing heart. I've never missed an opportunity that big, but I can relate to the circumstance. Now, I bring that up because, one, it is heartbreaking, but two, somebody shared with us, and I'm forgetting their name and I feel bad. Maybe it was Husfar. I don't remember.
I think it's D Freedom, the video.
Oh, D Freedom. Yes, sorry.
Yeah.
D Freedom found fan cam footage of that dark beer bash that you're talking about. This was not on television. Stone Cold comes out, saves the day with John Cena. This is not on television. My only thing to you is, if you feel solace in this in any way, the actual beer bash part was really fast. It, like, he hits the last stunner, they're out of the ring in 30 seconds.
Yeah, when I say beer bash, I meant even just, like, cheersing with John and Steve would have been cool.
But I can, like, there's sometimes that they're on their fourth beer.
Right, right. No, it wasn't like that.
It was just a quick one. So, like, you can just kind of, like, tie your shoe and miss it.
Right. Well, I made up for that beer bash, if you will, this week at AIW. We did a little beer bash with the PBRs.
Yes, it wasn't as messy.
And then, you know, in a heartbreaking turn of events, Hornswoggle announced that he needs to take some time away from the ring for a back surgery. So we almost did the major curtain call, and we all got on our knees and did that famous click picture MSG style, but it was Major Pod AIW style.
Right. I wrote it was an honor to share the ring with Swoggle. I've wrestled him. I've wrestled with him. So we hope that we see him back.
Yeah, he's not dead, and I'm sure he'll be back, but it's still a shitty situation for someone we love so much.
Yes. I'm sure that Swaggle will be involved in wrestling for the rest of his life in some manner.
Without a doubt, Hall of Famer.
Yeah.
WWE Hall of Famer.
Yes.
I'm not saying like Major Pod Hall of Fame. I'm saying WWE Hall of Fame 100%.
Agreed.
He's Vince McMahon's son.
Oh, yeah. And his that's true. And his son, Vince McMahon's grandson, Landon was there this weekend hanging out with us, so that was fun.
And check out the Major Pod YouTube channel within the next couple weeks, I guess, for the vlog of this weekend.
Yeah, sure. It's going to be a good one.
Yeah.
Jacos Jobin on YouTube. Bro, have you ever thought... Oh, this is a juicy question. I just thought it was funny, okay?
Okay.
Bro, have you ever thought maybe John Cena was telling you to take risks, like wear the internet title to the ring, run out to the beer bash, to hurt your career because he feared the Revolution?
No,
Cena obviously knew you were way bigger than what WWE saw.
No. Cena went to bat for me numerous times when he certainly didn't have to. So that's just ludicrous.
Hey, yeah. Matt, go punch Vince McMahon in the face. Just do it. Yeah, I don't think that Cena wanted to ruin your career. All right, Broski of the Week. What do we got?
The Broski of the Week.
Well, guys, the Broski of the Week, all you got to do is find this pinned tweet on my Twitter, which just talks about the pod. Quote tweet it, and in that quote tweet, leave the major review, but not major review, the review that you left on iTunes. I say major review because that's for the major rest of your podcast. But the review, screenshot it, and use the hashtag Broski of the Week to be eligible, and I will read it on here, and you will be the Broski of the Week. So, The Broski of the week is... Let me find this. Here it is. I thought I found it. All right. It's Mac Ruber, 6754.
MacRuber? MacRuber!
Zach Ruber.
No, not Zach Ruber!
Mac Ruber. As a young teenager, I was drawn into the character of Zack Ryder for two reasons. One, we had the same initials of ZR. Two, Zack was a goofy guy going for the gold. I was just a goofy kid trying to do my best in life. The show Z True Long Island Story was a way for me to connect to this character even more and root for him even louder as weeks and weeks went on. Now, 10 years later, Matt Cardona and Smart Mark Sterling sit down and bring back memories for them and memories for me. I highly recommend this podcast, as each episode is extremely enticing and is an easy listen, leaving you wanting more. Thank you to Matt and Mark for keeping the dreams alive for all the broskies out there. WWWYKI. Well, Zach, you are the broski of the week. He spells his name with an H, but you will be getting this, Zach. You'll be getting the 8x10, which you can get on mattcardonamerch.com. You can get the headband on mattcardonamerch.com, and if you're the Broski of the Week, and the exclusive Broski of the Week sticker. But Marky, we have a co-Broski of the Week, because this week at Toy Hio, little Broski, Aiden, he had a Broski of the Week sign. Well, we can put that picture up right now.
Yep.
I gave him a headband. I made him Broski of the Week, so we have two Broskis of the Week this week. So I appreciate that, guys. Really, really cool to meet the fans. You know, a lot of broskies at Toy Hio, even at AIW with like the old school shirts. Some people had like, I'm trying to think, some of the weirdest merchandise I signed, like the orange foam fists or like the weird Mattel mini wrestling buddy. But it's also cool to see these kids who there's no way they were watching the YouTube show back then. So that's really, really, you know, special interaction. So I want to, you know, give him the Broski of the Week title as well.
I saw that kid. I loved his sign. He put a lot of work into that, so that was awesome. Yeah. Still, 10 years later, little kids loving Broski of the Week. All right, let's talk about the week that was 10 years ago this week. But first, little word from our sponsors.
The Major Pod Network has a new tag team partner. Pabst Blue Ribbon.
Everybody needs some liquid courage to make their own weekly purchases. Scratch that figure itch and scratch that PBR itch.
Get your PBR beer, get your PBR hard coffee, and get your PBR stronger seltzer. 8%? If you're listening to this, you're already a major mark. Now it's time to become a major PBR mark.
Use the hashtag MajorPBR and post your pictures and videos of you Major marking out.
Pabst Blue Ribbon and the Major Pod Network, the new tag team champions of the world.
Of the world!
But we're definitely not getting any new figures from Mattel.
And we're back. Okay. Tweets. Matt Cardona. June 22nd, breakfast and gym with @m_Chiapetta, my best broski since kindergarten. One thing that I noticed you doing this week, there's a bunch of tweets where you're literally just saying, hey, everyone, follow so-and-so. It was like Tyson Kidd, Chiapetta, Big O, Dolph Ziggler, like you, just all your friends. You're just telling people to follow them, which was I thought was very nice because you at this time had way more followers than most people.
Yeah, so it was just kind of my way of, you know, giving them the rub, so to speak.
Yeah, especially the Twitter. You're the internet champion.
Yeah. Well, oh, by the way, if you're asking yourself what titles are behind me right now, if you're watching on YouTube,
literally, what is going on?
Yeah, these. Well, full disclosure, the Major Pod title and the internet title, they travel with me, so they're still in my gear bag. Okay. So right before we record, I'm like, oh shit, I need some titles here. So these are the FWF title and the FWF Interstate title, which will be. I think they will be crowned when we do FWF2 in September, October. So we have all the titles made, and you can order these from Wildcat Belts. And it's not a toy. It's not a replica. It's the real copy. Beautiful titles. Something that started as a listen, it started as a spin-off podcast, which you can still listen to all season one on the Major Pod Network, the Figure Wrestling Federation. And then we turned it into a real promotion. We've had one show, and we're going to keep going. So we need some real champions. So
I love it.
And they're beautiful belts.
Yeah.
And I can say that. Belts.
You know, we can talk about this later. I posted I posted something about the FWF, and people were confused because there's basically, at this point, two FWFs. And you have to be decisive in if you're talking about the one where we're actually wrestling or the one that we're playing with toys.
I know. I think this is so weird. I was thinking about this the other day. Like, I think FWF, the Figure Wrestling Federation, is the podcast and the fantasy booking with the toys. And yeah. I think, like, FWF, the real Fed, is just like FWF, like NXT. Doesn't really mean anything. You know what I'm saying? Doesn't stand for anything.
I see. Yes.
But I guess it could stand for the Figure Wrestling Federation because we're the major wrestling federation. I don't know.
We just have to say FWF Live, I think. FWF Live.
FWF Live.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Matt Cardona, June 22nd. No authentic shirt or headband yet, but you can finally create your own Zack Ryder merchandise on WWE Shop, wwecreate.com/Zack Ryder. What was that about?
Yeah, so they made this this little website. It was almost... I'm trying to think like what's a website I would compare it to. We're like, there's a couple pictures on mugs and like eight by, it was nothing cool. A poster maybe. I feel like maybe there was just like odd stuff like that. You know, great. You know, there was no actual shirt. I want to say it was like 8x10s and mugs and maybe some other shitty item.
Right. And they kind of do that now a little bit. They have like, you can make your own shirts or something.
Well, now, you know, now they do have like almost like the pro wrestling tees model, which I think is great. Right. But some of the designs on there are god awful.
Right. All right, Matt Cardona, follow at Kid WWE. He took care, but buzzed his hair. Woo woo. You know it. We went out to eat with TJ a couple weeks ago. Nice dude. Awesome. Had some great stories.
Looking so jacked.
Oh my God. Unreal.
I kept looking at his delts and I was like, oh man.
If he was wrestling right now, he'd have like one of the best physiques in professional wrestling, legitimately.
Well, I mean, unfortunately, we live in a time where that's not saying much.
Right.
But Tyson looks great. He would definitely win the Jesse of the Body Award.
Oh, man. Please. Sean Ross Sapp, put that on a clickbait title. Broski shoots on all of pro wrestling bodies in MC19. All right, last one. June 20th. Raw is Power to the People tonight. So I guess it's a guarantee that I'll be on the show. Woo-woo, you know it. We'll find out.
I am not on the show.
Yes. All right, matches that you had this week. So this was Capital Punishment. Okay, so that is June 19th. June 20th, you are at Raw. It is at the First Mariner Arena in Baltimore, Maryland. And you defeat Drew McIntyre. In the dark match, no time. So babyface, Zack Ryder, dark match, getting that crowd hot against Drew McIntyre. I bet you that was a hot-ass match.
I loved working Drew. It was such a physical, I don't want to use the word stiff, but it was definitely in there. And, you know, I've told this story before. I don't know if I've told it on here, but, you know, Arn Anderson once pulled me aside and said, I really have to lay it in there because I'm too pretty. So I got to be a little extra snug. So anyone who complains about my forearms and stuff, hey, Arn Anderson, one of the greatest, told me how to lay it in. But obviously Drew, former WWE champion, right? At the time, I believe.
Hell of a match this weekend, by the way.
What's that?
Hell in a cell match
for sure.
This weekend. Yeah.
This is pre-3MB, I believe.
Oh, yeah.
So this is just like floating after the chosen one, Drew McIntyre.
Right. This is super. This is dark match with Zack Ryder losing to Zack Ryder.
Right.
Drew McIntyre.
I would love working Drew. In OVW, we first met, and like I'm his first match on the road, like because they call him up like instantly. Hmm. He's with Dave Taylor, and he takes on Brett Major on SmackDown. But yeah, I always love working Drew. Very physical. Very. I don't know. The word, like, okay, so for instance, if we did like a loop of live events, mm-hmm. we never did the same match every single night, which I liked, because he'd always want to like, hey, we're first and like, we should be better on the card, you know, higher on the card. And he always wanted to go all out, which I appreciated because I wanted to as well.
Well,
so,
I guess you can tell why he is where he is now then by right. that work ethic, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
He kind of did a little bit, you know, I mean, you're doing a similar road right now, I think. You know, when he was let go, he really tackled the indies and did the best stuff that he could possibly do. So more power to Drew there. And then
absolutely.
the next night, and I have questions about this. So Raw is in Baltimore. The next night, SmackDown is taped at the Giant Center in Hershey, Pennsylvania. You are there. You defeat Titus O'Neil in 8:30 on NXT. Now, but this is the fifth season, so it's like a
Bro,
weird
I remember
like
this match. So this is like I believe this was NXT Redemption or something like that.
Yes.
So people who had lost were now still the rookie. So Titus was my rookie before, and I came in just to work him because I was his pro.
Right.
If I remember this match correctly, it's like a 2-seg match, and anytime you're in there with Titus, it's a fight, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's a fight, bro. I actually really enjoyed working Titus. We've had a lot of matches, you know, whether it be here
yeah.
or like when he was getting his shove skis later down the line to see how much he did improve.
Yeah.
You know, and I take pride in, you know, I believe I could have a good match with anybody, and I'm not taking anything away from Titus. But I think like I can mesh with anybody's style. I think that's one of my positive features, I guess.
Mm, yeah, yeah. So the question is, I mean, we've talked about this before. You must have just, they told you, hey, you're needed at SmackDown. So you drive to Hershey, Pennsylvania from Baltimore, which is, you know, not
And super there's
far.
A good chance they told me on Monday.
Right, all right.
You know?
So, but yeah, no flights, so you just got to go, you do this match, and that's it. This NXT season sort of never ends. It starts like there's this competition, then it kind of just molds into no competition. There's no pros. Pros aren't seen on the show anymore. Derek Bateman and Curt Hawkins are having storyline. It's like a very weird thing.
Right.
Do you have any memory of this? This is sort of a weird time for NXT.
I didn't watch it. I believe it. At this time, it's just on WWE.com.
Right.
I don't even know if it's on television right now.
Yeah.
Or maybe it starts on TV and then just goes to WWE.com.
Yeah.
I know, like you said, Hawkins was involved. I think like that's where like the Usos started picking up some steam.
Yep.
You know, because believe it or not, there was a time that WWE wasn't using the Usos, which was crazy because yeah. they were always super talented.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that NXT is where they really got the opportunity to showcase their abilities because they were always, you know, they just have it. You know.
Yeah. And your friend EC3 really kind of like started to like break out there. I feel like show his character a little bit more.
Yeah. I mean, I wasn't watching the show,
right?
If that's what you're asking.
Okay, so Capital Punishment, real quick, what's up in the WWE? This is June 19th, Washington D.C., Verizon Center, 9,850 fans, 170,000 buys. Santino Marella, Vladimir Kozlov defeat Heath Slater and Justin Gabriel in a tag, whatever tag match. Dolph Ziggler with Vicky Guerrero defeats Kofi Kingston by submission for the United States Championship. 12 minutes. Alex Riley defeats The Miz, so they're broken up. Singles match in 10 minutes. Alberto Del Rio defeats The Big Show by knockout in a singles match in 5 minutes. Ezekiel Jackson defeats Wade Barrett, who is the champion by submission, wins the Intercontinental Championship. 6 minutes.
CM I feel Punk like that match, they're just chanting, "We want Ryder" the whole time.
I got a good question about that a little later. Really? Wow, that's interesting. CM Punk defeats Rey Mysterio in 15 minutes, that match. I remember being great. Randy Orton, the champion, defeats Christian for the World Heavyweight Championship, 15 minutes. I remember that whole series being great. I think there's a figure out now with that Christian.
Yes, there is.
Evan Bourne defeats Jack Swagger in a singles match in 7 minutes. That's funny. Evan Bourne, Jack Swagger of AEW. And in the main event, John Cena defeats R-Truth for the WWE Championship, 15 minutes, which I, at the time, loved that Truth was getting that little championship shove. And then over on Raw, like we said, it was like, this is a funny story. I think a lot of people remember this. This episode was called Power to the People, where people voted for matches they wanted to see via text message and on WWE.com. After the event, WWE.com announced that they had major technical difficulties during the show and put it down to the 697,000 votes they received during the three-hour special show. The difficulties were during the Evan Bourne versus Mason Ryan match, where Sin Cara was meant to be Bourne's opponent, and during Kingston versus Ziggler, where Vicky Guerrero was meant to be banned from ringside instead of a 2 out of 3 falls match.
I kind of remember that.
Where, like, they're sitting there and like Sin Cara's like ready to get picked, and then it says Mason Ryan, and he's just like, oh no.
I don't remember specifics, but something like that rings a bell.
Yeah, that's super funny. But you didn't end up being on Raw, so it clearly was not Power of the People. But I remember this week almost like this is all ingrained, all this stuff. I watched that pay-per-view. I watched that Raw. All right, let's talk about episode 19. Normal open.
What's that?
Normal open.
The first thing I notice is I'm wearing these orange sunglasses that I found on some website, which later become like a signature Zack Ryder thing. In fact, one of my first pieces of merchandise are orange sunglasses that are based off these. But WWE could not like duplicate them for some reason. Because this is so specific, but if you look at the picture, if you watch the video, the lens is just one giant lens, almost like a Macho Man style glasses.
Yeah. Yeah.
They couldn't find that. So they had to find one that just looked like the same shape, kind of, but two lenses.
Wow.
And like me being so like anal about everything at that time, I was like, no, we need to find it with one. Yeah. It was like, you're either getting the one with two or you're not getting them. I'm like, all right, two works.
Well, I find that hard to believe.
And then we show signs from Capital Punishment and Raw. And
that's
all. Most of it is all WWE's biggest fan, our friend.
Who finding it, yeah.
Yeah.
One of the pictures, I don't know if you know who this guy is. I call him Brock Lesnar guy.
Okay, I know who he is. Yeah.
So he was in one of the pictures, and I'm like, oh, Brock Lesnar guy. He was at a very recent AEW thing. So he's still going strong. okay, next thing. Most prestigious championship is the Internet Championship, and you're getting challengers all over the place. So, to debut for the first time on Zetro Island Story, Yoshitatsu holding his figure, and then he basically just challenges you to a title match and then kicks at the camera. What's the deal here?
I think this was a way of just getting people onto the show, getting more characters onto the show. I loved wrestling Yoshi. Yoshi was somebody who... he just kind of, I remember it was like this new talent initiative thing, and like him and Sheamus and Tyler Rex all kind of like debut at once. And I worked Yoshi a lot, because on ECW, like we'd work a lot, and then we both got traded to Raw. So we'd work a lot all the time on house shows. And Ricky Steamboat would be the agent a lot, and he'd like almost produce these matches as if it was like Ricky Steamboat versus Macho Man, and we'd have like these so it was like so fun for me.
Oh, hell yeah. That sounds awesome. Yeah.
I will say that kick, that finisher to the back of the head, woof. That's no joke. And there's a trading card that it's Yoshi's card, but I'm featured just getting kicked in the back of the head.
So you have that one.
I do have that, even though I technically don't count it because it's not a Zack Ryder card, but right. It's cool. And yeah,
what's the deal with the action figure?
I feel like he was doing something like with the action figure on
for
NXT.
A long time, years.
Yeah,
he'd have it.
Yeah, and then for some reason I added an instant replay. I guess I figured out how to do that. There was no rhyme or reason to it. It was just a way to get more talent on the show.
Right. Then you get a quick Ziggler and Venkman thing.
Oh, you caught it this week.
Caught it this week, yeah.
Yeah.
And then you say, last week you got Dad a Molina cutout, so you show that from last week.
Oh, like previously on Z, True Long On Story.
Love that. And then you say, but Molina sent in a little message. So you go to Molina, who debuts for the first time. She's on the roster at this point?
Yeah, she's on the roster.
Okay, all right.
And then also, John Morrison, his arm kind of makes his debut.
Yes, I say kind of Morrison makes a debut, but I'm not sure. You don't see his face.
But he's there. It's clearly him.
He's talking for sure.
And this is just to continue the Zack Ryder's dad, John Morrison, angle that because the show can't just be about me. I know that. I need some stories along the way, and one is this Zach's dad, John Morrison story, which pretty much goes like from the first time my dad debuts in one of the earlier episodes all the way to the end.
Right.
So we tell it the whole time.
Morrison's on SmackDown now, so you're not really running into him. So the way you get him on here is they send in a video.
And John is somebody who he's always working. He's always being creative. He's always doing things outside. So like he could appreciate that I'm doing this. And like if I needed something from him, he would do it no problem. And even now he you know, I bounce ideas off him because I know like, you know, he's up at 5 a.m. working on stuff for himself.
Right. And yeah. And what I always appreciated, you know, when you guys were still in the WWE, he would still help us. You know, when he wasn't, he would help. He would do stuff for us in the major pod. Right. And then, you know, when you guys were both together in the company, he would still help us. I mean, probably a problem him being on our shows and stuff. But
right.
Still, always helping us out. So thanks, John.
Yeah, always, you know, super creative, super talented. You know, and then in the ring, you know, his work speaks for himself, you know.
Phenomenal. did the whole storyline as John Morrison in Retromania, because that's the storyline. Okay. You have to be John Morrison.
Well, I believe it's Johnny Retro.
Johnny Retro. So I got good at his finisher, which is a tough finisher to do. but basically, Melina says that your dad is bothering her and has been calling her and says he's going to take her to a palace of wisdom, which I have no idea what that means.
That's one of John's weird, like, slogan catchphrases things.
Oh, okay. Morrison laughs it off. He says he's just a mofo. Melina says if he sees you guys, she's going to slap, you know it. And then she says at the end, Zach, make him stop.
So, yeah, just nice, a way to continue that little story. Yeah,
good little performance there. Broski of the Week is a little British kid, very cute. He does the whole show, all your catchphrases. He actually built like a background to the show. I thought that
he
was awesome.
He beats up a Rey Mysterio.
Right.
His brother sounds like Rey Mysterio. Hey, listen, I love that. I love, you know, it's a little, like, I could picture myself doing something like that. So that's got to win.
He has a headband too, which I thought was cool. Next segment, Broski goes to Hollywoowoowood.
This has Scott Stanford written all over it.
Nice little graphic. Stanford's there. So he talks about 4 movies, and you're going to see him right now. You see the posters. So who made these posters?
Stanford had someone make them. And this is like now it's so easy to make these. I could probably do it. But back then it was pretty tough.
But this was really good. Like this was good. Like John Lucas Reyes does this for us in the major pod often. So this was like John Lucas Reyes level, like the it wasn't just.
I wouldn't say it's that level, but it's good.
It wasn't
good for
just
2011.
Like Brian like cutting out somebody's head and putting it on.
Right.
This was pretty good. But so the first one is Saving Private Ryder. Then you get G.I. Bro. Then you get Zach to the Future, and
Zach
he's playing
the two. Zach it's the sequel.
And he's playing the music to these. You're playing the music to these, which is like dangerous. And my favorite, Finding Primo, like Finding Nemo, phenomenal. Primo's face on the.
It was a fun little segment. This is Scott just showing his creative side, and you know, it was entertaining. It had to do with me, and it ate up time, which is important. But you know, like you know, Scott did go the extra mile to get these graphics made, but then I had to get like the Hollywoowoowood. I had to get that made, then added the jingles and edited it together. But that was all Scott's idea. He's given like the descriptions of the movies. Really, really funny. It was entertaining. It was great.
And then this was great. You said you could vote on Raw, but you weren't even an option. Let me show you what I was doing. And then it goes to you are in the dark in what looks like a hotel room or your room.
It's my apartment.
Your apartment. And you are jerking the curtain. In the dark. So you're sitting there and you're pulling your curtain on the window in the dark.
You get it?
Very clever. Jerking the curtain in the dark match, baby.
Jerking the curtain in the dark. And I'm wearing, you know, I had to wear like some sort of like neon trunk so it would get picked up
I see
in the dark.
Yeah. And we know, you talk about this often. You have no problem with that first match. It's a great match. You guys probably had 10 minutes. Crowd's hot.
You obviously want to be on television instead.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Especially at this time, it's people power, whatever it was called. Like, this is a perfect way, in my mind.
Okay, well.
Just do one little vote ski and see if I win. And if I don't win, I'm wrong.
Okay, so I don't want to backpedal. People say I backpedal. You have said before on the Major Pod, in the Q&As or whatever, that, those opening matches are super fun. But so at this point in your career, hot as hell, 100,000 views a week, that pissed you off.
Okay, yeah, those opening matches are fun in the sense that, like, if that's the match you have, of course you're going to go out and you want it to be the best possible match it could be. But I want to be on the show, 100%. You don't want to be in the dark match.
Okay.
I mean, if anyone says they want to be in the dark match,
yeah.
I mean, I they need to get their priorities straight.
So you walked into this Raw thinking, oh man, if they put me in an option, I'm winning that.
I firmly believe if they gave me or gave the fans a chance to vote for me, I would have certainly won.
Yeah.
Maybe not in February, but I would have won in June 100%. Yeah. I mean, it depends where they put me again. Like, you know, like if they put me against like Cena and Punk, probably not.
Right.
But
If you didn't win, you would have lost your internet championship, I think. But
well, no, because WWE didn't recognize the title, even though WWE does recognize the term WWE Internet Champion because it's on the list of things I can't say.
But you can say Internet Champion.
Well, I have the... do I have it right here? Ooh, where is it? Oh, no. Our good friend, our good lawyer, Michael Dawkins, he got me the official trademark. I had it framed somewhere.
You have so many trademarks now. We just got FWF.
I just got FWF. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, yeah, the U.S. government recognized me as the internet champion. So,
right.
But not the WWE internet champion. WWE can own that.
All right. So that's it for the episode. There was anything else in your notes?
At the very end, I do a little picture right before the close. It's just my dad and Big O from Superstars the week before on Long Island because the camera caught them.
But when it showed your girlfriend, it was not your girlfriend.
It was not. No, it was not.
So weird. That's so weird that they would just show a random girl.
Well, I think they just needed to find somebody, you know?
I guess. You're like, and my girlfriend's there. And then they're like, find a girl. Find a girl.
Yeah.
Like, it just seems so insane. All right. Let's finish off the show. But first, a little word from our sponsors. Broski, what do we got for the Are You Serious Bro? Are you serious,
bro? Yeah, guys, real simple. All you got to do is tweet something that pops me. Use the hashtag Are You Serious Bro, and I'll give you one of these 8x10s. This comes from @ChrisRiz. At Pabst Blue Ribbon, I live in New York City, and I can't find the hashtag Pabst Stronger Seltzer anywhere. Hashtag Major PBR. Hashtag Are You Serious Bro. These Stronger Seltzers, these 8%, they're my fave, but I can't find him in Orlando either. So luckily I have a hookup with PBR.
Yeah. But he said, that there's certain available locations you can't get them. So.
Yeah. So we're working on that. You know, it has some this distribution problems right now. But,
also,
we
signed at Toyhio a PBR cold brew coffee. And I'd never seen those.
Yes.
I want to try that.
PBR is so great. We've seen some of the footage of the little commercial. We've put a couple pictures up and a couple teasers up there. It's going to be really, really fun. I think you guys are all going to enjoy it. At first, I was like, how are they going to take a whole day and put it into 45 seconds? But they figured out how to do it.
Phenomenal.
So we have a lot of cool stuff with PBR in the near future. I don't want to, you know, spoil everything. But, you know, we have the major fitness challenge. It's, you know, it's not really like a competition, like who can lose the most weight or who can get in the best shape. But we just want people to participate. So we're, you know, always use the hashtag Major Fitness Challenge, whether you're working out or whatever, eating right, whatever. But at Live 9, Major Pod Live 9, coming Saturday, August 21st, we will give away a one of one, unless I ordered another one for myself. So it might be one of two. I can't remember. But a PBR/Major Pod weight belt from Cardillo Weight Belts. The same guy who made Hogan's belt. Same guy who made Macho Man's belt. So we're really excited about that. And then there might be another PBR belt being made that's not a weight belt. I'll just say that.
All right. Know your bro. What's the know your bro, Broski? What's the rules there?
Really simple. Just ask a question using the hashtag know your bro, but ask about like next week's episode, and then Mark will surprise me with that, and we'll send you an 8x10 also.
All right. Andrew Thompson at Hal_OCE asks, do you remember the first time the whole crowd was chanting, "We want Ryder, woo, 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 woo"? I feel like it would have been around this time, and did that make people in the back have to think more about pushing you?
I remember it vividly during this Ezekiel Jackson Wade Barrett match, because like Ezekiel like mentioned it to me. Like, yeah. I'm sure it was like difficult to work when they're chanting for somebody else.
Yeah.
And that's, listen, that's not my intention. I didn't want that, you know.
Yeah.
I wasn't upset about it. You know, in my mind I was doing everything I possibly could and it was working. Like, what else did I have to do? I mean, God damn it. They're chanting my name. Shows I wasn't even in the building.
Oh, so you weren't even at Capitol.
Wasn't even in the building.
And we already know you didn't watch it.
I did not watch it. So I was getting tweets. I was getting tweets 100%. But yeah, no, I can only imagine. Like, listen, we've all been in a match where the people are not into it. Or they're into something else, you know? Or they're doing their own chant. Or somebody has a fucking, like, beach ball, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Like, we've all done that or been in that situation, and it sucks. So of course I would feel bad for guys if they're working and they're chanting for me.
Right.
But at the same time, like, I didn't feel bad because what do you want me to do?
Yeah.
You know?
I'm just so over, bro.
Well, no, that's not what I'm saying, but I was doing anything possible to get noticed by WWE, and, you know, eventually we get there. Eventually we get there.
You get a garden.
It's funny
though.
Because, what's that?
You get a garden gnome.
I get a garden gnome. But, you know, it's funny because we were just in Cleveland all weekend. But I think, like, Cleveland is where it all kind of really starts to click. It's the Hugh Jackman situation with Ziggler. And that's in, like, the fall time. But, you know, they start this summer. It's definitely, like, the summer of Punk and the pipe bomb. But it's also, for me, selfishly, it's like things are starting to pick up. You know, whether I'm getting TV time or not, I'm getting merch. So there's people in certain avenues of the company who are recognizing me. The hard work starts to pay off around this time.
Mm.
We're almost there.
Yeah. All right. Well, characters debuted Yoshitatsu, Melina, and Morrison. So big episode here. Back this episode, Scott Stanford. Your dad was not, because it was just the last week. This episode clocks in 265,957 views right now, and it is 5 minutes and 10 seconds. ProWrestlingTees.com/MajorWFPod, ProWrestlingTees.com/Matt Cardona, ProWrestlingTees.com/SmartMarkSterling. Today I'm wearing my Toy Hio shirt given to me by the promoter of Toy Hio. Thank you very much. We had a great time. Gerard, Ohio, really cool shirt. Macho Man's like playing with toys on it. So yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff for us. What else have we got to plug?
So ProWrestlingTees.com/Matt Cardona. I just dropped this week. It's the shirt that I will wear at GCW Homecoming against Nick Gage when I win the title. It's the LI with the L and the middle finger, covered in purple blood. It's a nice shirt, perfect for a nice hardcore death match. And that shirt is available on ProWrestlingTees.com/Matt Cardona, courtesy of TTD. And then on MattCardonaMerch.com, we have 8x10s available. We have internet title keychains, Broski of the Week headbands, old school Zack Ryder sunglasses, retro figures, a lot of cool stuff there. But yeah, this summer is going to be an interesting summer. I'm, you know, the pandemic is finally, I don't want to say it's over, but the world's starting to open up, and all my weekends are full, whether I'm doing Major Pod stuff or wrestling shows. So if you see me coming to a town near you, buy a ticket. That's all I can say, really.
Well, I got a big thing to plug. Friday, 2 weeks from now, Friday, July 9th, on my Big Cartel, I will be putting up for sale these Smart Mark Sterling exclusive brawlers.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
There's 250 on planet Earth, but I'm not selling 250. I'm going to be giving away a lot. So I'm putting up for sale 100.
I need at least three my way, Mark.
Exactly. Yeah. So 50 of them are going to a bunch of people.
Right.
So 100 signed, 100 unsigned. This is going to go up 11:30 for the Major Pod Patreon and 12 noon for everybody else.
I don't think they're going to make it to everybody else.
I don't
else.
Think they're going to make it to everybody else. So I'm very excited about that. You get a 2 weeks notice going into that July 9th. And I think they're going to be reasonably priced and all that. I'm very excited. And the whole deal is I'm setting this all up right now as far as the shipping. I bought all the stuff that I need. I bought a Rollo printer today.
Congratulations, big boy.
Yeah. So
it'll change your life, dude.
Yeah. So theoretically speaking, if I do this correctly, these go on sale on Friday. I'm going to be boxing them up on Saturday. Everyone, they will be going out to everybody on Monday. So
wow,
it's not going to be
great,
one of those.
Turnaround.
It's not going to be one of those like pre-order bullcraps. I have these things. So
right.
You're going to get them in hand as soon as possible. July 9th, 2 weeks from now.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of any other things to plug. Obviously, you know, Patreon, if you want to listen to this podcast early, patreon.com/major pod network.
And ad-free.
Oh, ad-free, of course, which is important. But if you're signed up to the Patreon now, I think it's almost like the best time. Like, part of me is like, well, why weren't you signed up before? But the other part's like, wow, you lucky son of a bitch, because now you have a year and a half of all this bonus content to listen to.
I think 2 years, dude.
Oh, 2 years. Okay.
Oh, but there's a lot. 2 years because you've done 108 Let 'Em Breathes.
Wow.
So, it's awesome. So many, the 108 unboxings that Broski did. And yep. There's just amazing amounts of content on there. All right, take us out.
All right, guys. Still, I have not figured out the Facebook situation. Still working on that. So don't like me on Facebook yet, but follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, buy all the merch on MattCardonaMerch.com, ProWrestlingTees.com/MattCardona. Enjoy a nice stronger seltzer or a regular PBR or a hard coffee or now the hard cold brew. And most importantly, take care, spike your hair. Jeff!